Hello viewers, my name is Oleg Uchigozie from OCI City Center. In this very video demo, I'm going to show you how to host your website and other content in a local server. Now, it is ideal when you want to test the functionality of your website before publishing it to a web server. Okay, now for the demonstration purpose, I'm going to make use of the WAMP server. I have already installed it in the system. I'm going to launch it. Going to launch WAMP server. Right, it is launching the WAMP server. On the taskbar, the icon is going to appear and it is going to show green. You can see this green, it is indicating that the WAMP server is running properly and correctly, okay, and it is ready to use, to be used. All right, now let me show you the dummy website that I want to, and also the reason why we need to host it on a local server. Now I'm going to show you, this is a website, this is the content of this website. Let me launch the index file here to launch this website. You can see it is running on a local folder here, and now it seems that everything is displaying properly, but the problems occurs when I visit a page that contains PHP code, okay, like form content. Right, let me click on contact here. You can see what happened. This PHP code cannot run on a web on a browser locally on folder. Okay, it cannot run. It need to be served. Okay, it need to be run or hosted on a server, and this server can be a web server or local server. And for the demonstration purpose, I'm making use of a local server. Okay, and I can test the functionality of this content, and if everything works properly, now I can now publish the website to a web server. Okay, it will save me a lot of time and also data because of internet. It costs me no data to test all this content locally. All right, so let me, but all other pages that does not contain script function properly, and this is if I can visit different pages and view the content. Okay, so now let me show you how to host this very website locally. I'm going to close this tab. Now to do that, you need to go to the root directory of the web server. For the WAMP server, you go to your C drive, and here you locate, if you are running 64-bit, it is going to name WAMP 64. If it is a 32-bit operating system that you are running, you will only see WAMP. Okay, there is also, if you have already installed WAMP or XAMPP, there is also, you can also use any of these server. Right, now I'm going to open the this folder WAMP. Now on the root directory of this WAMP server is the www folder. Okay, I'm going to open it. Now this is the This is where I'm going to place my content. This is where I'm going to place my content. Let me open the content I'm going to place inside this very folder. WW. Right. Alright. This is the folder that contain the website that I just show you, this folder. Okay, now if I drag this folder into this very let me show you what I'm about to do now. Now this folder contain the website or the content of that website. So this is it, the folder. It contain all the website and index file, right? Now I'm going to rename this folder. Let me name it test site, right? Just renamed the folder. I renamed it test site. Now I'm going to drag this folder or copy it into the WW folder of the and that is the root directory of the WAM server. Now, and that is all. All I need to do now is go to my browser and type localhost. In my own case, I'm using the IP address. Now, I will now type test site. Test site is the name of the folder that contain the website content. Okay, just press enter. You can see now that it has now displayed my website and I can now check everything. Now if I go back to the contact page that contain form, you can see now it is now showing simply because it has been hosted locally. Right? Okay, if I click on this apply page here, that it contain more form also, and you can see everything display properly, and I can now fill the form. I can connect this form to my database and test everything and check its functionality before publishing the website on a web server, right? Okay, that is a simple step to host and test your website locally.